I did it, then I did it right. This ain't happened for me overnight. Bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Down to business, I ain't playing nice. So ahead of y'all, I'm out of sight. When you poppin', they don't wanna slice. Greed and envy, that's a part of life. Mediocre, that just won't suffice. Keep myself grounded, that's a piece of me that I won't let go. No matter what level I reach, I promise to hold it close. Ain't gotta tell me this hitting different, man, I already know. How are you claiming we had a baby, we ain't never spoke? I don't be out here with random women on the road. They want a DNA test to prove it, I'm like, here you go. I could've saved you a bunch of time and told you the results. Looking for us money from me, you ain't gon' get it though. Historic, rain on my parade, I keep walking and ignore it. Part of the game, yeah, it comes with the territory. It's just another day, man, I'm used to it downpouring. It's nothing.
It's the National Football League, presented by EA Sports. Tonight, it is all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Denver Broncos taking on the NFC champions. I'm Brandon Gaudin alongside Charles Davis, beyond thrilled to be bringing you the Super Bowl. All the pomp, all the circumstance, all the pageantry. It doesn't get any better than this, partner.
I'm loving sharing this booth with you, sharing this moment, this type of a game. For all the teachers who said we'd never make it, we're here.
And we talk these last couple weeks about the buildup, the anticipation. I think these guys are just ready to get out there and get this thing started.
And I know that both coaching staffs have spent considerable time trying to figure out how to best bring their team up to a peak without taking them over the edge and causing a lot of issues early in the game.
And you don't think much of a pregame speech is needed for this one.
I think the pregame speeches were the shortest all year. If they didn't just say, let's go get them, guys, they probably talked too much.
Now second and three. They'll drop the throw. This one swung out to Williams. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Broncos first down.
That was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that? Second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
So first and 10 now from the 30. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Second and 9 now. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked by the linebacker, Brian Asamoah. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Well, short of them returning it for a pick six, that was about the worst start you could ask for in this one, because your advantage of getting the ball first is gone, and they're set up a short distance from your end zone. Now you're counting on your defense to prevent a touchdown, and your offense, you better be ready to come out swinging on the next series.
First and 10, Taylor now. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
Second and nine.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left.
19 right.
Back to throw. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on.
So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field.
On the jump. 70 Timberwolves.
A gift for Taylor running right side. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. And he's got his man in stride, complete. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal.
If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
A chance for the first score of this Super Bowl. Here's first and goal. They'll run here with Taylor, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
No daylight for him to run through there, and he ran into the defensive tackle, and that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
Back at the 5 yard line now, second and goal. They'll look to throw, rolling to his right. To the right side, complete to Taylor. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal. They'll look to throw here. That one behind his man, incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on third and goal. Let's see what they do on fourth and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on fourth and goal. So they've got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on fourth down here. They'll set up a throw. It's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had the play call on fourth and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And the Bronco defense comes up big.
On the ready.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Remember last time out, they threw the interception on their first drive. Good news, their defense backed him up, so it's still 0-0 here as they begin their second possession.
Yeah, and one great way to judge a defense, how do they handle what we call sudden change when all of a sudden, you know, it goes against their offense and have to run out in the field and try to put out the fire? Give this one great kudos for getting out there and not letting that interception lead to points. Excellent job by them defensively.
So not quite out of danger just yet. Still backed up a bit, but only need a few inches here on second down. They'll stay on the ground with Williams. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
First down, he'll drop to throw. Looking left sideline, it's complete.
He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of the Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one, the man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
A lot still to go here in Super Bowl 61. We have reached the end of one quarter of play. We'll be back in just a moment.
Nothing, nothing, our score. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
19 tight.
Now back to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Now a second and 10. Not liking the look, they'll change the play.
On second down, Williams. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35.
What do they have for this? Third and 11.
He'll look to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out.
Well, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted.
And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense, came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively if they get in that fourth down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so. But maybe because they held them, they might go for it again.
Here we go, Jack.
Here's second and 10.
18 Rattler. Hurry, hurry.
Up the middle, here's Taylor.
Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. On third down, here's Taylor. They find some open field here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards on third down as the drive rolls on. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told them, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
Ready.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
And now the rookie's free. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That time they pick up a 24 yards on the keeper. First down.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it. Most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync,
stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Ball on the 27. Here's second and three. Completes it. His second catch in the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
They go play action here on first down. And oh, it'll be intercepted. And the Broncos are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe break the ice a little bit? Like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now this throw caught left side. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. He got 29 yards that time. To throw now on first down. Screen play set up for Williams. And he is going to lose yardage here. The Broncos in a hurry up, trying to get to their positions and get set quickly. Again, he'll drop to throw. Throw here is incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw again. He releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Andrew Booth picks it off. And a very good return as he'll take it all the way up to the 40-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw. Because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll start at the 40, so great starting field position following the interception. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down.
Any questions of how they'd approach this drive were answered right there. They come out throwing, and they get a nice pickup here toward the end of the first half.
Nothing, 19. 19, Light.
Now a play fake here on first down. He'll buy some time right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Second and 10. Looking to throw. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
The plan was clearly to challenge them by sending a blitz on second down, but even the extra guy couldn't catch him in the backfield, though. He doesn't scramble for a first, but he does get the last lap by evading the blitz and getting beyond the line of scrimmage.
Over the middle, it's complete. I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. So the defense able to force the interception, and the offense working their way to field goal range and able to get three out of it.
Yeah, and give them credit for that. They took the ball, maneuvered it downfield, and while they couldn't get exactly what they wanted, which was a touchdown, they did get 3 points out of it. So they paid off what the defense gave them. Both sides would be thrilled with that.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. Denver has the first down, the play going for 15 yards.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Come on. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
On play action, they'll throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. And they brought the pressure there just right up the gut, didn't they?
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, when you've got so many different responsibilities as an offensive line, you got to deal with the nose tackle, the two defensive tackles or ends, and then sometimes you just can't account for everyone. The linebacker slipped free. Kept off the scoreboard in this first half, but here toward the end, they're trying to change that one fell swoop, but that winds up incomplete.
Certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. They'll throw now on the final play. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. He takes this near to 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Ready. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And I think you'd have to say their coaching staff, all things considered, had to be pleased with their performance in the first half of this Super Bowl.
Definitely pleased, doing their best not to show it to their team, of course, because as you and I both know, their mantra all season long has been finish. Get the job done. They know how close they are to lifting that trophy. One more solid half of football, and they can do exactly that.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Running straight ahead, Taylor. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll set up to throw. He gets this into the hands of Taylor. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 18 yards there, the first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down.
Dragon 60.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. A short throw to Ingram. Yeah, he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
I got kicked out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
They give to Taylor out of the gun. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
So from the 37, here's a second and 9.
Ready.
And off the option, he'll try and run with it. What a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Nice pickup, 10 yards and a first down on the keeper.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. On the handoff, Taylor. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. They run once more with Taylor. And they got it inside the 10 at the 8. Like we
see our first touchdown of the game. Here's first and goal. Here's a quick throw caught out wide. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. They'll try and run this one right up the gut. And he will push his way forward down about the 3-yard line. Third and goal, a big play in the Super Bowl. They'll drop the throw. And this will be swung out wide for Taylor. Touchdown! Jonathan Taylor from 3 yards out. And the Dragons take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
He will return this from deep in the end zone. Fights off the tackle at the 20. And he returns this to the 22. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a 2-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked in each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because they don't get some kind of points here. The next drive, that could make this a free possession game.
A pass there complete to Sutton. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. And they're going to speed things up here. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. Pass the 20. 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Javonte Williams. 50 yards. And the Broncos are on the board here in this Super Bowl.
Well, I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
And this one won't bounce their way. It's covered up by the hamstring. I know they're down, but starting the third quarter there with the onside kick, what'd you think?
Well, I think that they're looking at it as we may not have as many possessions in this game as we want. There may be that sense and that feel. But they've got to go ahead and make something happen. Steal a possession, try and steal some points, and get themselves right back in a position to try and win the game.
On the handoff, this is Taylor. And down to the 46-yard line here. 53 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is bring the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly. 60 Bobcats.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now third down coming up. And that'll do it for the third quarter of Super Bowl 61. The culmination of the season and the crowning of a champion after the fourth quarter, which is coming up next. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. This offense so far on third down, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. He'll drop to throw.
Johnson able to get him down for a loss of 11. And it brings up fourth down.
Well, you just knew that these rushers were eager to do that today. Put him on the ground. Their plan? Introduce themselves individually to this rookie quarterback. They said alone a big way there with a loss of double-digit yards on that sack.
Now here's Ryan right now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. Touchback. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And we're at the time of this Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly. Trailing here in the fourth quarter as they begin this drive first and 10. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Here's a second and 5 now from the 25. They're going to look to throw.
This one swung out to Williams.
And they work this right upfield across the 45. Looking to speed things up here, Ron, with some tempo. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10, as they've got things rolling on this drive. Williams. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
An awful lot of congestion in the middle third of the field, but how about our defensive tackle right there? He didn't just hold the line. He provided some push and smacked the ball carrier down for a loss.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss.
70 Rangers, 70 Rangers.
They'll set up a throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, to watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Now a 10th carry. Here's Williams. And they're knocking on the door now. There's a good run there. Going to take this to about the 10-yard line. 101 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in this Super Bowl. Here we go. First and goal. They'll try and run. This is Williams. Into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Javonte Williams, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Broncos have regained the lead in the second half of this Super Bowl. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now 14-10. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
They'll come up first and 10 here.
Hey.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
Oh, this defense knows. Fourth quarter, they need to make a play. That one was right for the taking. Could have changed the complexion of the ball game, but it winds up incomplete.
Here's second down. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Off the option, here's Taylor. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Here's second down and three. On the option to give to Taylor here. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now.
19 tight.
Off the option, here's Taylor. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. They'll come up now. This is second and long.
18.
Back to throw. That's caught downfield by Addison. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow.
What a game this has been, and what a drive that was, Charles, to take the lead here late in the fourth quarter.
And partner, that's a job well done by everyone, from the players to the guys calling the plays. And if I may introduce just one downside to the mix, might be a little bit too much time left. Enough on the clock for a final last-ditch effort to try and steal this win away.
Point after, right down the middle. So it's now a three-point game here in the closing stages, as a field goal now can only tie it. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. This is first and 10. He'll look to throw. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Is
going to be fierce again as they come up second and 13. Now a handoff, Taylor with it. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. But how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go.
And here's Ryan right now
as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Looking for the checkout bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback.
Here's first and 10.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And so much for the game-winning two-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close, defense isn't backing off and just giving you easy throws. They're playing aggressively as well, and they end up picking that one off and sealing the deal for themselves.
Extra point splits the uprights, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Here's first down.
After the pick six, they go right back to the air. Escaping the pressure right. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. So there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game.
Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And, Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence, and made it happen for a victory.
Hey. I count this money, then I count my blessings. If I ever took an L, then it's still for lesson. I'm the one, ain't no second guessing. Tried to dim my light, but my soul fluorescent. Wait, I tried to stay, but depressing. I even prayed to God, he ain't get the message. I'm living in the present, they gon' feel my presence. You can't dim my light, cause I'm luminescent. I rose from the ashes of the section. I seen a stranger in my own reflection. I point the in my own direction. I would've did it for my own protection. Keep debating about the GOAT, I'm the one like 2, 3, 4, 5. How you playing both sides? How I make 1 million, 2 million, multi. How I make 8 figures, 8 million, 4 times. And I was underutilized the whole time, it's rigged. I guess they couldn't find a gold mine, you dig? The sheep sleep for me, but the ghost co-sign. I stopped thinking about the future, cause we got no time. The world changed. Damn. The world changed. Yeah, I tried and failed. I see my best friend's jail, but betrayal was the real pain. Damn, the world changed. Look, I built walls around the house, networking. All these bloodsuckers, I just hope it's networking. Soul searching, broken hearted with my chest hurting. But I was gifted with the best curses. I'm suffocating and my weight keep fluctuating. I showed love how to
You hating? Damn, I'm the greatest, but that's unrelated. I either overstay my welcome or I'm underrated. Lately, I've been trying to wake sleepers. The fake woke and the gatekeepers. Too shallow for big fish. I stay deeper. We all.